فإن لم يجد شيء من الطعام ودخل وقت المغرب والسنة أن يعجل بالفطر ينوي الفطر وإذا نوى الفطر أفطر. نعم.
And if a person can't find any food at all and the Maghrib time has come and we know that the recommended act is to break the fast as soon as possible, then a person in his mind, he makes the intention to break the fast and his fast is broken.
نعم. والسنة في السحور أن يتسحر على تمر. نعم.
And also the sunnah in terms of making suhoor, the morning meal, the pre-dawn meal, is that a person does it upon dry dates.
نعم. وكذلك الاكثار من قراءة القرآن.
And also increasing in the recitation of the Quran.
وصلاة التراويح في المساجد جماعة.
And praying صلاة التراويح with the Muslims in congregation in the masajid.
ويكثر من الدعاء.
And a person, he increases in his dua.
وكذلك الاعتمار في رمضان.
And also a person performing Umrah in Ramadan.
وكذلك إذا سبه أحد أو شتمه يقول إني صائم.
And also if a person insults a person who is fasting or curses him or swears at him, then he says إني صائم, indeed I am fasting.
وكذلك التصدق في رمضان يعني الاكثار من الصدقة كما هو كما ورد هذا عن النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام.
And also, as has been mentioned by the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, somebody increasing in charity during the month of Ramadan.
ويستاك في كل رمضان في جميع الوقت في النهار سواء كان بعد الزوال أو قبل الزوال, قبل الظهر أو بعد الظهر لا إشكال. نعم.
And also, a person using the miswak or brushing one's teeth, cleans one's teeth. This can be done as much as one wants, inside Ramadan, outside Ramadan, before Dhuhr, after Dhuhr, it doesn't matter.
وكذلك يعني المشاركة في تقديم إفطار الصائم للصائمين. نعم.
And also participating in or helping in breaking other people's fast or providing food to break other people's fast.
نعم. يكره للصائم أمور. نعم.
And then there are certain things which are disliked for a fasting person to do.
ذوق الطعام لغير حاجة.
A person tasting some food without any necessity.
والمرأة إذا كانت احتاجت لذوق الطعام فهذا من مباحات الصيام.
If a woman is cooking and she has a need to taste a little bit of food, then this is something which is permitted while fasting.
فيباح للصائم ذوق الطعام لحاجة.
And therefore it's permitted for a person who is fasting to taste a little bit of food due to a necessity.
والاغتسال.
And also having a shower, making ghusl, permitted.
ولا اشكال فيه. نعم. وكذلك التبرد بأن يدخل مثلا ويكون تحت المكيف لا اشكال في هذا ويستظل. نعم.
And a person cooling themselves whether it's under the AC or for example under the shade.
وكذلك ليس من المفطرات بلع الريق يعني أجمع هذا الريق وابتلعه لا إشكال في هذا لأنه لم يدخل شيء إلى جوفه لأنه بعض الناس هدانا الله إياه في رمضان يعني يخاف ويظن أن هذا من المفطرات وتجده دائما يبصق. نعم.
And also a person swallowing saliva, this doesn't break a person's fast. Sometimes you see certain people and they think that if I swallow my saliva, this is going to break my fast. And therefore you keep spitting. So this doesn't break a person's fast because you haven't put something new in your mouth.
يحرم عليه ولا يفطر بلع النخامة يعني البلغم. نعم. لأنه لم يدخل شيء إلى جوفه. لكن هذا من المحرمات ولا يفطر بهذا.
And again, from those actions which is impermissible, but at the same time it doesn't break a person's fast, is a person swallowing his mucus.
ويحرم عليه ولا يفطر بهذا فعل وقول كل محرم فعل وقول كل محرم. نعم.
And every action or every statement which is not permissible for us, which is a sin, then during Ramadan it is impermissible and a sin, but it doesn't break a person's fast.
غيبة,
backbiting,
ونميمة,
slandering,
وغيرها.
And these are the actions.
نعم. بهذا يعني ذكرنا ولله الحمد أغلب ما يتعلق بصيام الفريضة. نعم.
So by this we've mentioned or we've studied an overview or a summary of most of that which relates to fasting.
ننتقل الآن إلى صيام النافلة. نعم.
That's the obligatory fast. Now we go to the voluntary fasts.
صيام الاثنين والخميس مستحب.
A person fasting Mondays and Thursdays, this is recommended.
والاثنين آكد من الخميس.
And fasting on Monday is more emphasized and more highly recommended than fasting on Thursdays.
وصيام ثلاثة أيام من كل شهر.
And also, a person fasting 3 consecutive days every month.
من أول الشهر أو وسط الشهر أو آخر الشهر.
Whether it's the beginning of the month or the middle of the month or the end of the month.
والسنة أن تكون في الأيام البيض الثالث عشر والرابع عشر والخامس عشر من الشهر الهجري.
And the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and that which is recommended, that these 3 consecutive days of fasting in the month should be done on the days of the full moon, and they are of the Islamic month, the 13th, the 14th, and the 15th of the Islamic month.
صيام يوم وفطر يوم.
And also, a person fasting one day but breaking the fast and not fasting the other day.
صيام يوم عرفة لغير الحاج.
And also, from the highly recommended days of fasting is a person fasting on the day of Arafah as long as he is not doing Hajj.
كذلك صيام يوم العاشر مع التاسع والحادي عشر
من المحرم.
من محرم. نعم.
And also fasting the 10th of Muharram, but combining it with fasting the 9th or the 11th.
صيام التسعة أيام من ذو الحجة لدخولها تحت الأعمال الصالحة. هذا إذا لم يرد شيء في صيام هذه الأيام تدخل ضمن الأعمال الصالحة. وإن ثبت شيء في تخصيص هذه الأيام بالصيام يكون هذا يعني مع الأول نور على نور. نعم.
And also a person fasting the first 9 days of Dhul Hijjah. And this doesn't mean that there's a specific evidence that we should fast on these days, but because we're meant to do good deeds, and therefore fasting is one of the good deeds. But if there is a particular evidence, then it enters into this.
صيام ستة أيام من شوال.
And also fasting 6 days of Shawwal, i.e. the month after Ramadan.
لمن أتم صيام شهر رمضان.
For the person who has completed fasting Ramadan.
فلو بقي عليها أيام من رمضان يعني قد أفطر فيها لابد من القضاء أولا ثم بعد هذا يصوم ستة من شوال.
So if a person has days left over from Ramadan that you have to make qadha, then first you have to make up these fasts, and then afterwards you can make up the 6, you can fast the 6 days of Shawwal.
والأولى أن يجعلها متتابعة ولو فرقها لا إشكال.
And it's better for a person to fast them consecutively. However, if he splits them or divides them, then there's nothing wrong with this.
في أول الشهر يعني ثاني أيام شهر شوال.
And it's better for a person to fast these 6 days of Shawwal at the beginning of the month, i.e. beginning from the 2nd day of Shawwal.
نعم. ولو أخر لا إشكال.
And if a person delays them in Shawwal, there's no problem.
نعم. ثم كذلك صيام شهر محرم وشهر شعبان لكن لا يتم هذا الشهر يعني كامل بالصيام.
And also it's recommended for a person to fast the month of Muharram and the month of Sha'ban, but he doesn't complete the full month like Ramadan.
نعم. بعد هذا نذكر الصيام المحرم.
And then after this we're going to mention that type of fasting which is not permissible, impermissible type of fasting.
صيام يوم عيد الفطر ويوم عيد الأضحى.
A person fasting on the day of the 2 Eids.
وصيام يوم الشك أي اليوم الذي يكون قبل رمضان آخر يوم من شعبان.
And also a person fasting a day of doubt, and that is the last day of شعبان before رمضان.
يعني إن صام هذا اليوم يوم الشك من أجل الاحتياط فهو آثم نسأل الله العافية والسلامة.
For example, you have a person and he's not sure of whether Ramadan is going to enter or not, and therefore he says, I'll fast the last day of the month of Sha'ban, so I know that I've covered Ramadan. If a person does this, then he is sinning.
لكن إن كان من عادته أن يصوم موافق هذا اليوم آخر يوم مثلا من شوال يوم اثنين وكان من عادته صيام يوم الاثنين وصام من أجل السنة في صيام يوم الاثنين فلا إشكال في هذا. الإشكال في أن يصوم يوم الشك احتياطا. نعم.
Let's say it's from a person's normal practice that he fasts on this day. For example, the normal practice of one of you is that you fast every Monday and every Thursday. And the Monday just so happens to be the last day of Sha'ban. In this situation, a person can fast the last day of Sha'ban with the intention of that it's his normal day of fasting, like he fasts every Monday and Thursday. Not with the intention that this is a fasting of a day of doubt.